1, 2, 3. Hey, hi. So today we are going to talk about importance of probability and statistics in like probability and statistics in machine learning. Probability and statistics in machine learning. So like whenever we talk about machine learning, we hear both of these words, probability and statistics, because basically these are kind of roots of machine learning on which it is based on. If you talk about neural networks or deep learning or anything, probability and statistics are the roots, and always it will be, because in machine learning, whatever we do is we interact with our environment. We interact with world, we interact with people, the solutions that we make using machine learning are there to solve world problems and natural problems. So like, let's talk about why machine learning is important. So let me just, I'm sorry, let's talk about why probability and statistics is important. So what exactly happens? First, let's understand how our world works. So like, whenever you go out on a road, so let's assume it's a road with these cool dividers. These are not cool, whatever. So with these cool dividers, whenever you enter a road, so you encounter cars or buses or people, and those elements, those are cars, buses and people, are coming randomly. Like you can see two cars a minute, you can see three cars a minute, you can see four cars a minute, or you can meet two persons a minute, or you can also meet your friends by chance. So this is a kind of model which is made using probability, occurring of each car or occurring of each person is based on a probability. Like, everyone's got a probability. So like, everything is coming from a probability distribution, which we'll talk about in a few minutes. So first, let's make a bit of a base. So it's always good to learn things with basics. So let's learn about a bit of probability and statistics, and then we'll move on to why it is important or why it is required in machine learning. So let's start with two things, two words. One is simple, and another one is population. Simple and population. So what are these? Both of these are types of data. Both of these are types of data, and the criteria in which both of these differ is quantity. Let's take an example. So if I have collected data of weights of people in India, let's say. So let's assume that there are 7 billion persons in India. I'm just talking about India right now. Okay. So let's assume there are 7 billion people in India. And if I take the readings of weights of all the 7 billion people. So let's say I have a data that consists of ID number, which could either be name or some unique identification, and here I'm recording weights. So let's assume I've taken 7 billion weights. So this data which has all the existing population's data is called population. And if I take a bit part of it, let's say I've chosen only 5 lakhs out of it, then that data will be called as sample. So like, if I talk about population in this scenario with a bit more precision, so if I take people's weight, actually it's not people's weight, it is people weights. I don't know, I'm a bit kind of confused in English words, so never mind, pardon me. So if we talk about people's weight, then these two words, simple and population, will be differed very easily. So if I, let's say there are infinite people in this world. So if I take every one of them's weight, then that data which is consisting of all the possible people's weight, then that data will be called as population. And if I take a bit of it, then that data will be called as simple. So why we have talked about this thing? Because it very much resembles with the word probability. So now let's talk about two more words. The first one is relative frequency, and another one is probability. So relative frequency is the thing which we use to study in our junior classes, or sometimes in higher classes also if you opt for mathematics sometime. So then what relative frequency means? It means number of favorable outcomes upon total number of outcomes. So this is the definition of relative frequency. And the definition of probability also is kind of same, but the difference is the type of data. When we are calculating relative frequency, then we are taking simple as our data. So let's say I'm calculating relative frequency of people having weights 60 to 65. So and I've selected only 5 lakh people out of 7 billion. Then, and assume the people having this this weight are, let's say, 3 lakhs. Then relative frequency will be 3 by 5. But if I talk about probability, then I'll have to take all the people inside this. So it will become 7 lakh out of, let's say, 4 lakhs. Some people increased. So that will be probability. So whenever we are talking about population, that is probability, and whenever we are talking about simple, then that is relative frequency. So in machine learning, why probability is important? Because all of the actions that we take, all of the predictions or classification, whatever we do, are based on probability. So what we do in machine learning, we have a data. And everything is based on data. So let's say we are having data of housing prices. So let's assume we are predicting housing prices like this, or let's say we are predicting car prices. So the data will be consisting of features. Let's say one feature is ID number, one is color, number of doors, and size and price. So all of these five features will form a kind of a probability of each price, and then you, like, whenever you are going to predict, then all of these, it's kind of complicated to understand right now, but this was an overview of understanding why probability is important in this domain, because a world works upon probability. Every event is happening over probability. Everything is coming out of a probability distribution. Now let's talk about this thing. What is meant by everything is coming out of probability distribution? Let's talk about what are probability distribution, which is very important topic if you want to learn machine learning in future. So what is probability distribution? It is a kind of a formula, or we can say a graph, which consists of a random variable, or we can say some event, let's say not exactly event, but let's say people weight on x-axis and its relative frequency on y-axis. Okay, so let's say we are having people of having let's say 10 kgs, 30 kgs, 10 20 30 40 50 kgs, 70 kgs and 90 kgs. So what I will do, I'll plot the relative frequencies here. So what is relative frequency? So let's say I'm having two people out of 10 for having weight as 10 kgs. Then this thing will go a bit up to like whatever the answer is, let's say 2 by 10 lies here, so this will come here. Let's say we are having 4 people out of 10 having 30 kgs of weight, then this will, let's say, come a bit above, and like all of the values on y-axis are between 0 and 1 because it is having a probability. So let's say we have plotted this graph and we got a kind of this curve. So this is a probability distribution which consists of random variable on x-axis and probability on y-axis. And what we can do is we can take out random numbers out of it. Let's say I want to take out the people having weight 50. So what I will do is I'll input probability of this thing and I'll get that number out. And like this is how you know, from like there are many kind of many types of specific distributions out there in mathematics, or we can say statistics, which can give you random events out of a distribution. So like if we'll generate weights out of this distribution, then we'll be getting people having 50 kgs maximum. Let's say I've taken out 1000 people out of this distribution, then out of that I'll get people having 50 kgs of weight maximum, and then I'll get people having 70 and 30 kgs of weight, a bit less than 50, the people having 50, and then in a decreasing order as compared to the decreasing probability. So this is how events are occurring, and the most famous and very common distribution is Gaussian distribution, which is this one also having a formula, but we'll not talk about that. So so if you want to model world and natural phenomena, then we'll need to use probability out there. And if you talk about statistics, then like probability and statistics are kind of husband and wife, so they work together. So statistics is also a very, very, very useful thing, having two types of statistics, descriptive and inferential. So let's talk about that a bit also, and then we'll end this session. So let's talk about a bit of statistics. So the first type of statistics is descriptive statistics. Descriptive statistics, and second one is inferential statistics. So in descriptive statistics, as the name suggests, we describe our data by some statistical tools such as mean, mode, median, or the things which we used to study whenever we started studying statistics. So like these are kind of statistical tools which give you some information about data. Let's say mean gives you central value, median gives you also central value, but that is kind of less accurate, we can say, or less like we'll talk about it later in future videos. But statistics are two types, descriptive and inferential. In descriptive, you describe your data or you explore your data, and in inferential statistics, you take inferences out of data. Let's say you want to conclude which party will win in the upcoming elections, then the tools of inferential statistics can be used there, such as hypothesis testing or ANOVA or t-test, and there are many tests out there which you can use in inferential statistics in order to make inferences, or in Hindi we say anuman lagana, right? Like, so that was statistics and probability, a bit of introduction. And we've also talked about why we use these in machine learning, why it is having a bit of importance in here, because everything is stochastic out there, everything is random out there, and whenever we deal with random events or random things or stochastic things or kind of uncertain things, we talk about probability. And that is why machine learning requires very much probability, because all the algorithms that are working in machine learning are somewhat working on probability at the very low level. So that was the reason or overview of probability statistics based on machine learning. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned.